Shri Ashwini Vaishnaw.
Thank you, Chairman, sir. I rise to support the Taxation Laws Amendment Bill 2019. Sir, in my statement, I would like to focus on the tax structure, how this will be very good, how this will be helpful for structural change in the Indian manufacturing sector, sir. Sir, I welcome this bold and timely step. This step in reducing or rather rationalizing the tax structure will increase the competitiveness of Indian industry. It is also a fiscal stimulus, and it will develop the capital base of the Indian industry, sir. A question has been asked, what is the structural improvement that this step will take, sir? Yes, there is a structural improvement, sir. As we all know, the Indian industry has been dependent on debt as the primary source of capital. The equity base is a very low base in the country, and for various reasons, the primary reason has been the distortions which have been introduced by the tax policy. And the first distortion has been a very high and complex corporate tax structure, and the second distortion has been the dividend distribution tax. Because of these two distortions, the equity base has always remained very, very low. And most of the projects, most of the industries, everybody has depended upon debt as the primary source of capital. That's not a very sustainable form, as we have seen in the last 10-15 years, the debt bubble which crashed and which gave us all this pain that we are right now in. So this particular rationalization of tax structure will help the corporates to deleverage and increase the retained earnings and reserves and surplus, and that will basically once again get back into the equity base of the industry, which will lay down the foundation of the structural growth for the economy, sir. That is the fundamental reason I would like to support very strongly, and I thank almost across the political spectrum, everybody has supported this tax rationalization inside this house, outside this house, and inside other house of the parliament, sir. Sir, I'll just like to give a perspective of where we stand in the entire global scenario, sir. Today, sir, there was a phase when entire industry, practically the entire manufacturing base of the world shifted towards China. Because of certain apprehensions which got caused because of the actions taken by the industry there, supported by the government in China, the IP rights were not fully protected. There was a large scale apprehension among global industry that whether the IP rights will be protected or not. Second, the labor cost over a period of time increased in China. So even before the trade war started, there was a flight of industry, especially the manufacturing sector, which had started moving out of China, sir. That is the base which will generate hundreds and hundreds of employment in other countries like India, Indonesia, the entire Southeast Asian countries. So that is one factor which country after country has been looking at, trying to attract those manufacturing industries, and many of them have successfully done, like Vietnam, and I'm glad that our government has taken a bold step of removing that distortion and creating a base by which the industry which is migrating out of China can come in and set up their base here, sir. What are the key factors that industry look at when they want to shift from one base to another base, sir? First and foremost is the political stability. We are very glad we have a democracy which is vibrant, where anybody can have a say, people criticize, people take pot shots at others, but still, at the end of the day, we find a way by which we change governments, we find a way by which we re-elect our governments or change the governments based on their performance. So that kind of democratic setup gives a very strong vote of confidence to the global industry. The second is looking at the dispute resolution system in a country, because every contract, everything will have some way, some disputes will arise. So is there a proper judicial system? Is there a proper dispute resolution system? I'm very glad, sir, this government has brought out a very good arbitration amendment bill very recently, and that is changing the way entire world looks at our dispute resolution mechanism, sir. The third and most important is the tax regime. That is where the lacuna was still there, and by this ordinance converted into the bill, which will be converted into the law, sir, that tax regime distortion is significantly, at least 50% of it is reduced. And I'm very thankful to Honorable Finance Minister. In a very wise way, she has kept the provision that if you want to take the reduced tax rate, then you have to give up the all the exemptions which were there. I think we have debated in Parliament and outside Parliament multiple number of times that the exemptions, the plethora of exemptions which are there, have to be reduced, and by this single very wise move, the exemptions will take a sideline and the people will focus more on productivity and less on tax planning. I think that's a very major structural change which is happening in the people's mind also, sir. Sir, the tax rate reduction is not an isolated phenomenon in India. I would like to give a picture from 1980s onwards, how the tax rate has reduced globally. In the 1980s, the median tax rate, corporate tax rate, used to be globally between 40% and 45%. In 2000s, it came down to 30%. And as in 2018, the median tax rate globally is 20% to 25%. So we are very well within the global trend, and it is needed for the country to attract the manufacturing industry. So that's why this was a very timely and a very bold move, for which I really commend the government for taking this action, sir. Sir, there has been a criticism that will this increase the fiscal deficit? Yes, by a very small percentage. For a 200 trillion rupee economy, 200 lakh crore rupee economy, this will be just about 0.7%. And in my personal opinion and my calculations of the Indian economy, sir, this is definitely a space which is available to us, and we should be utilizing more of the fiscal space, even though there is sometimes a fear is created that the rating agencies will hammer us. No, sir, it will not hammer us. For 10 years, we have been in the BBB family. So even if we go up to 4-4.5% fiscal deficit, I think we are a very comfortable space that we are in, sir. Country after country has used, whenever there was a recession or there was a downturn, whenever there was a slowdown, country after country has used the fiscal space. The recession of 2008-9-10 period, sir, France had 7.2% to 5% of fiscal deficit, Japan had 10.5% to 7.9% fiscal deficit, UK actually had double digit, 10.1% to 7.5%, US had 13.2% to 8% fiscal deficit. So our government is very, very conservative, very concerned that this should not cause any inflation, and inflation has been contained. But I would recommend, I would request that please use the fiscal space available to us. Don't fear the bond ratings. Definitely we have a space which can be used to bring the economy back into a double-digit growth rate, sir. The manufacturing sector, why it is very important, although this has been debated and it is very well known, so I'll just put some data facts based on my experience and study, sir. 1 rupee invested in manufacturing sector will bring the highest multiplier possible compared to any other investment that we make, sir. A demand of 100 rupees created in the manufacturing sector creates a downstream demand of 192 rupees. So that is the kind of impact manufacturing has. And that is precisely the reason why country after country has been welcoming the manufacturing sector, bring them in, because that is where the employment is generated. My estimate is if we remove the dividend distribution tax, we might be foregoing 41,000 crore rupees as the tax revenue, but we will be attracting at least 5 to 7 lakh crore extra investment, which will in turn generate even 55,000 crore extra revenue and about 28 lakh employment it will generate, sir. So by removing one distortion, we have really taken a very big step forward. By removing the second distortion in tax, we can really take the economy on a totally new level, sir. That's my request, sir. A very small comparison of the tax rates in different countries will give why it is important, why it was important, and why this action was timely taken, sir. China is 25% tax rate today, sir. South Korea is 25%, Taiwan is 20%, Vietnam is only 20%, sir. Indonesia, 25%, Singapore is only 17%, sir. These are the East Asian. Look at the developed world, sir. European average is 21.5%, sir. EU average is 21.5%. US is just about 27%. So that is the scenario in which we are in. So I commend the government for taking a very clear, timely and bold decision. We all must support this. This will lay the base for structural growth of the economy, for employment, for creating jobs which are really, really needed for our next generation of the country, sir. Thank you, sir. With that, I support the bill, sir.